Hello friends, welcome to KB Tutorials. So in this tutorial we are going to learn how we can do JavaScript execution in UiPath. So as you can see, we have this particular site where we have username and password, and we'll enter this username password as the values are shown above, and we'll click on the login. And this entire thing, usually when we are entering in using UiPath, we'll use type into activity, right? But in this case, I am not going to use type into activity. At the same time, to click on this login, I am not going to use click or double click activity. Whereas I am going to use JavaScript to enter these values, and I am going to click on this button using JavaScript only. So let me show you the demo first, then we'll see how we can develop this script. As you can see here, I'm not using any type into activity here. So let me run this and show the demo, then we'll see how we can implement from the scratch. Now you can see I have started executing. It entered username, password. Then once it's logged in is successful, it is showing me the successful message. So this I'm going to implement now. So let me take one empty sequence now. Inject.js is my script name, guys. And yeah, please do subscribe to my channel, guys. I have seen so many people are coming into my channel but not subscribing, but I request you all to subscribe to my channel and watch all the videos on this playlist. So let me start here. I have opened the sequence. So to open the browser, I'm using the open browser, and I'm choosing the Chrome as my URL. Then let me copy paste this particular URL here. So this is my URL. Okay, now let me use inject.js activity, inject.js script activity here. Okay, then if you see here, script code, this is where I am going to enter all my script. So I'm trying to maximize it so that you all can follow on this. So let me enter two double quotes here, then enter function. Okay, so in this function, so what we have is username and password, right? So let me inspect and find out what are the values available. As you can see here, for ID, that means for username, I have this ID. So I'm going to use this, guys. And how do I enter into the text field using JavaScript? I'm going to show now. So just use document.getElement by ID, and what is the ID? You enter that ID into the single quotes. Okay, then value is equal to what value you want to put. You put in the single quotes because we already have a double quotes here, so don't put double quotes. I have this admin. Okay, now let me click on this and let me show you the output, how it is coming, is it coming properly or not, because we need to divide every problem into small step, guys. Then only we'll understand how it is working. So I'm dividing this problem into the small steps. Now you can see admin has been entered. That means my flow is correct. That means my script is correct. Then simply you can copy paste this for the password also. So document.getElementById, and for the password, just see what is the value, what are the selectors are available. Okay, so if I just inspect on the password here, now you can see I have this selector, text password. So I'm going to use that into this one. So I'm just identifying based on the password, and the value I'm going to set is admin123. These credentials are already given as part of the example, guys. Okay, then to click on this login button. Okay, now we have entered username and password. Now we need to click on this login button, right? So simply get that selector. So this is my selector. So copy that here, document dot get element by ID. This is this one. Okay, now to click on it, you can use click function. Directly you can use click function. Okay, that's it guys, click on OK. Now let me run this script and show you how the login is happening. Okay, so simply run file. Now you can see script is been executing in the background. Now you can see it is completely executing. Usually JavaScript execution is very fast on the browser because it directly goes to the DOM and will change the values. Because of that functionality, it usually very fast guys. Then how will I know the login is happened successfully or not? Okay, so once the login is happened, I am going to check any element is presented or not. So let me check on this dashboard. If the dashboard is presented, then I am sure that login has been happened properly. If the dashboard is not presented, that means login has not happened. That means there might be an issue with the application or there might be an issue with my script. Okay, so how do I validate that scenario here? I'll simply use element exist activity. So this element exist, what it does is, if the element is existing on the DOM, it will going to throw me true. If not, then it will throw me false. Okay, so I'm going to identify this element. Okay, now let it load properly. Now just go to your selectors and try to observe it, because I don't want it to be static. Now you can see it is came properly dynamically. Okay, now let's use something like flag as a variable, flg as a variable, and based on this, if the element is existing, then the flag value set to be true. If not, then the flag value will be false. So based on that, I'm going to determine. So I'll use if condition here. I'll put flag here directly. Then I'll just drop a message box here saying login has been successfully happened. Login successful. The same message box in else condition is login failed. Login failed. Now let me try to run this script. Before that, let me close this one. Now let me run this script and see how the output is coming. Now I started running, the browser is loading, it is entering username, password, clicked on it. Now you can see logged in is successful based on this dashboard. Okay, this is correct. But let me try to change this and see if we can get the login fail scenario or not. So let me try to put, let's say something like this, index as something like 1. What I am going to get here, I have to put it in try catch. In that case, let me run this, because I am going to get maybe file element not existing. Let's see, username, password, it still executes because it has to identify that element. Element is not presented, so it has to throw me an exception here. Instead of that, it has to throw me an exception. Yeah, so you can simply, in this kind of scenarios, what you can do is you can simply put this in try and catch. So when the exception is coming, that means there is something wrong with your code or the application, then you can put it in a catch and you can caught that, right? So yeah, superman. I thought it comes differently, but we got login failed here. Okay. When you use element exist, that if element is not existing here, what I actually thought was, like, the element is not existing, I thought it will throw me the catch statement. Instead of that, it is returning the flag value as false. Even that could be possible, and I got this as a failed. That is good. If I use element find element, when I use the find element, I'm going to get exception. Let me show that. This is, you know, just a trial and error guys. Don't take much serious into this. I'm just trying to show the different trial and errors into this. So yeah, let me just copy and paste the same value here and see. Actual code has been completed. but I want to show different values. And so if I put the same selector over here, which is not going to be there, then I should get as false. Not false, sorry, I should get exception, because the element it is returning, usually element is not there. Your element is not there, because of that I should get exception in case of find element. So it's waiting, I think the wait because of that only, so I should get that exception here. When you use that, be careful with this kind of scenarios, guys. Here the element exist activity is returning me. Now you can see activity timeout because of that exception. Okay, here find element is returning me UI element where the selectors are wrong. That means the element itself is not there, though. So where the UI element comes into picture, it won't be there, right? Because of that I got this exception. Whereas element exist, it will check for that selectors. If the element is not there, it will simply throw me the flag value, that means the false. And using if and else, I'm going to handle that. Okay, so I hope it's informative for you guys, and I hope this code you have understood. Simply just every line in the JavaScript, you have to put it in function, and to set the values, we need to use value method, and to click on it, you need to use click method. To identify any element, I'm going to use find element, and here I have ID, so I'm using get element by ID, document dot get element by ID. That ID I'm going, and I'm setting the value to it. So I hope it's informative for you guys. If you have any doubt, let me know in a comment section so that I can help you more on this. And do subscribe to my channel, guys. I have seen so many people are not subscribing to my channel, so please do subscribe to my channel and click on that bell icon for more videos like this. Do watch all the videos on playlist. There were close to, I think there were close to 100 and 112 videos on UiPath itself. So do watch. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you.